If you're just now joining us, we build computers in these small wooden cases. Last week, we tested these three computers thermally against each other to see how they did. So what could we possibly be doing with this 420mm radiator? It's massive. It's not going to fit in anything we have. 140mm fans, massive water block. What are we up to? But first, let's get this mini fridge, computer in the house. This is the Obsidian 1000D made by Corsair. It is massive, also weighs 93 pounds. Not fun getting it up the stairs. Here's a perspective on how big it really is. Literally 4 times the size of the Cyberwood cases. It's here to replace this 360mm radiator that's just been blowing hot air on both GPUs. After we're done installing the 420mm radiator, we will compare thermals before and after. But why would I be installing a 240mm radiator in the back? Because I'm also gonna build a computer inside of a computer. Yep, you heard me right. We're gonna put a second motherboard and a third GPU in this computer. Before we get into that, we remove these three fans and install the 420mm radiator. We reinstall those three fans so we have the total of 6 push-pull all set up as an exhaust. Next up, we turn it on and check thermals. The CPU is already running 7 degrees cooler with the 420mm radiator. Next up, we'll test it out on a Cinebench R23 run and a Cyberpunk benchmark. Before we start the test, take a look at the improvement with the radiator at idle. Now take note on how much lower the Gigabyte GPU temperatures are. The reason for this is initially it was installed in the top position. We found just from trial and error that both GPUs were happier installed with the EVGA on the top and the Gigabyte on the bottom. Overall, both GPUs are much happier without a radiator blowing hot air on it. Here's the recorded temperatures after a 10-minute run on the R23 benchmark. Another great improvement across the board. Mid-70s is what I like to see max after a 10-minute run on the R23 benchmark. Unless we're talking about a 13th gen Intel or AM5 processor, then that's a different story. One thing to note here is the customer is running a overclock on all cores at 5 GHz, so 74 Celsius is very fair. Last test, Cyberpunk benchmark. We ended up running a little bit hotter on the CPU with the larger radiator because it's set up as an exhaust, where before the 360mm radiator was set up as an intake. Even though it was in the middle of the case, there were 8 intake fans right in front of it. As far as graphics go, this test was done at 1440p, ray tracing off with ultra settings. Two reasons the Gigabyte GPU was so low was because of the position swap we did earlier and because it wasn't being utilized during this test. For the EVGA GPU, it ran a little bit hotter but still within safe margin. We could continue testing all night, but I'm already seeing a massive improvement thermally. So now, let's have a little bit more fun and install another computer inside and redo the thermal test. Installing the motherboard would have been much easier if I would have removed both graphic cards. However, I like a challenge. To power this board, we're using an EVGA 850W SFX style PSU. Once everything's connected, we flip the button on the PSU to make sure the board is getting power. And power is good. But we run into our first problem here. The radiator was making contact with the drawer sliders for the top radiator. So with that being said, a 240mm radiator cannot be installed on the back of the case. So we just zip tied it up for now to do the test. The second issue we ran into was the EVGA 3080 would not fit. The fan shroud was getting hung up on the case itself. Which makes sense because the Obsidian 1000D came out 5, maybe 6 years ago, and there were no graphic cards this thick back then. So we used this Zotac 2070 instead. After installing the GPU, we move on to the backside where we run into a little issue. We're not doing any wire management right now because the ITX board is coming out after the test.
Don't touch it. Don't breathe. Because like before, we'd close this one, that one would pop. Close that one would pop. So Alex had a great idea to remove this hard drive bracket from the back of this, and that gave us a little bit more freedom. I'm sure we could remove more and make life easier, but then how much fun would that be?
Now that we have it buttoned up, we'll check the back panel to make sure everything's connected and ready to turn on. Fun fact, we could connect 15 monitors the way it's configured right now. Wow, just look at that beauty. What you're looking at here combined is 96 gigabytes of RAM, 22 cores, 44 threads, 56 gigs of video RAM, 660 millimeters of combined radiator length, and 16 fans. Now let's move on to some thermal testing. I could not get any of our major components to idle in the 30s. It was no surprise, but due to these temperatures, we would not continue forward with any further testing. I wanted to compare results with the testing we did last week, but we also couldn't install the 3080, so it wouldn't have been a fair comparison. Well, let's be honest, nothing would be a fair comparison against this build. So we removed the second motherboard, third GPU, and second PSU, and then complete the wire management. This was the last and possibly most challenging part of this build. With just the fans alone, there's 32 wires and connections. We did the best we could, but it's still a little chaotic down in the basement as there's literally 7 different SATA connections. But most important, the side panels close freely. I would like to thank my buddy Alex for allowing me to build a second computer inside of his computer. This has been the most challenging and exciting build that we've done so far, and our first build of 2023. I'd like to thank you all for watching. I hope this was as exciting and interesting to watch as it was for us to build. Coming up next week, we're going to unbox and review this Z790i ASUS ROG Strix motherboard, followed by installation of a 13900KF with a 3090 Ti and 64 gigs of DDR5 RAM. We hope to see you there. Please like and subscribe. Until then, we'll see you next time.